Before I had tremors, I would say I was a normal grandma, normal mom, normal life. The tremors changed everything. I was pretty much destined to have essential tremors. My grandfather, my mom's dad, had essential tremors. My dad's mom had essential tremors. I'm one of six kids, and five of the six of us have essential tremors. I'm blessed with being the worst. I first noticed the tremors when I was at church. Just seemed like my head was shaking, and it was more and more noticeable. Then it started in my hands, and my voice, and my core. I can't even try to explain to you how hard it is. Every little thing that you do, from buttering bread for your granddaughter to holding a newborn baby, and you don't trust yourself. I was willing to try anything. So we tried numerous medications. All the side effects weren't worth the small amount of relief. And I thought the focused ultrasound would give me my right hand back.
Beverly had a debilitating tremors that initially began with mild tremors about 10 years ago. I first met Beverly a few months ago when she was referred by one of my colleagues looking for a focused ultrasound treatment.
Parkview is the second health system in Indiana to offer this modality, and we started treating patients in January. Beverly is actually one of our early patients. We felt this was a good option for Beverly. For her, she felt that she wanted something that was non-invasive, was outpatient, and didn't require a great deal of follow-up.
I wanted to have tea parties with my granddaughters. I wanted to, most of all, color with all the grandkids. I wanted to blaze a trail for my family. I wanted to present options or make it more accessible in Fort Wayne. I didn't have a choice, so I went for it.
Getting wet. What would you like to improve? A couple of things that you want to give me on this specific.
I want to be able to color with my grandkids. And if this is hereditary and is passed to them, I want them to know they've got options.
The concept is that by putting a lesion into the brain, we can impact certain tremors and block them. What it involves is using sound waves, which are highly focused, that can actually penetrate the skull, basically killing or lesioning the cells. We use the anatomic identification of this area, but we also verify it during the procedure. So we will stimulate, deliver a dose called sonication to the area to see if there are any side effects. And then as we take it stepwise through the procedure and deliver more of a dose, we can identify if we are suppressing the cells.
What makes really special at Parkview is that Dr. Young, my neurosurgeon, and I, movement disorder neurologists, we work together. So we're in the procedure together. So she's giving me a real-time feedback on whether we're in the right location, also minimizing side effects. And that's what's really fine-tuning where it is needs to be. That's the art of medicine.
Just do your very best. Look at 3D the entire time. This will be the last one. Am I good?
We're good.
The day of the procedure, when I came out of the MRI, and I know I wasn't this steady, but it was close.
It was very gratifying to see Beverly's early result. You couldn't expect a better result in one of your earliest patients, so we were very happy.
We did it.
Thank you.
It was worth all. all of it.
Beverly's outcome was fantastic. It was great. Even immediately after her tremors are controlled, 1 week after when I saw her, it was improved. And a few days ago when I saw her, 1 month post-procedure, it was phenomenal.
High five.
High five, baby.
Woo! Life is back to normal and back to where I can take things for granted. The only difference is I'm aware I took that for granted. Having the focused ultrasound gave me back my right hand, and this is just one more stride, one more option, one more miracle for people like me, and couldn't be happier. It's awesome.